I've been getting into HEMA for the last 4 or 5 months, maybe, especially a bit more intensively in the last 2 months, let's say. And I've been having to do everything on my own because, unfortunately, I don't have access to a club. So there's some great resources on the internet that I use, and but for the rest, I have to practice on my own. And I actually have some fencing partners, which is great, but none of them have any experience in an actual HEMA class, so we're having to. Obviously, the going is a bit slower. And so today, I'd like to just make a quick point, which is about shields and their grips. And the reason I'm making this point is because I made a mistake in what I now consider to be a mistake in the construction of a shield, which maybe I can help other people avoid. Although, if you're familiar with HEMA, then I might not say anything new or revolutionary to you, but then again, shield use in HEMA is relatively unusual in the sense that a lot of the fencing treatises that we have deal more with civilian weapons than military weapons, and shields are not very practical to carry around, so they tended to be a military weapon. That's one thing. The second thing is that the fencing treatises really take off in, I guess, the mid 14th century, but even more so in the 15th century, when plate armor, especially in the 15th century, full plate armor started becoming more and more prevalent. And so the use of shields sort of started going out of fashion on the battlefield, although they were still used until much later. But the thing is shields are not as big a topic in HEMA as they would be if we were trying to reconstruct battlefield combat, especially of earlier time periods. Excuse me, I've got a cold. So yeah, just a quick point about shield grips, which I didn't figure out for myself. So this shield here has a strap grip, and that's pretty straightforward. I mean, you can make your strap grip have several orientations, as I did here. I've got actually two grips on this, which change somewhat the way the shield sits in my hand when I hold it. Anyway, pretty straightforward. The real issue I have here is with the center grip, boss-held shields, as opposed to the strap shields. And that's what I made first. You see, my interest was always more the ancient world than the medieval world, and so I've always had a big interest in shields like the Roman scutum. And so, well, I made all these shields by myself, by the way. And this is a, well, it's not really a scutum. It's not curved and it's not rectangular. It's more of a stretched hexagonal shield of the type that might have been used by the Romans and various other tribes, Celts and Germans perhaps in antiquity. So you see this kind of representation of shield I'm not sure if there's actual hard evidence that the Romans used them. I know they're often depicted using them in modern art, and I'm assuming that evidence must come from somewhere, but I actually haven't been able to find much myself. Although I do believe there's evidence of Germanic tribes using these shields. Anyway, I'm getting ahead of my point here. So really, the point I wanted to make is that being used to these kinds of big, elongated boss grip shields, I kind of naively assumed that the obvious way to orient a shield grip is horizontally, like this. And that's, as far as I know, that's how most scuta, I guess, plural of scutum, whatever that is, were constructed in this way. That's my understanding. Although, interestingly, I think there are a few examples of scuta with the grip being with the grip in the other direction, basically, so with a vertical grip. And then I actually didn't know of any examples, knowing the scutum, I didn't know of any examples of shields that had vertical grips. I only knew the examples of shields with horizontal grips. And so when it came time for me to make this, a sort of Norman kite shield, teardrop shield, Now, a lot of you might think that these shields were always strapped, which is indeed how you often see them depicted. However, there are a few depictions of teardrop shields that appear to be center grip. There's a few, I know of a few medieval illustrations where you don't necessarily see the arm of the person holding the shield, but the shield looks like it's held out in front of him too far to be a strapped grip, and therefore must have a center grip. And some of the illustrations also show a fairly large boss, which is what you would expect for your hand to be able to fit in there. And so I basically, I was fully aware that a lot of kite shields were strapped, but I wanted, for the sake of experimentation, to make a kite shield with a center grip. And my initial reaction was to, well, as you can see here, this one is actually vertical, which is, I think, the right way of doing this. But initially, I made it horizontal, so the grip sat in here like this. And luckily, I realized that that was bad before actually peening it in. And so I was able to fixate it temporarily just with some rope to try out how it felt with a horizontal grip. And it felt really bad. It felt like I was going to break my wrist at the slightest shock, which is not the case with the scutum. And that's really the point I want to make here, is that I think I've discovered a property of body mechanics that would predict whether the center grip would be vertical or horizontal based on how you use the shield. Now, it's kind of hard to do this because obviously I knew of examples of shields like the Viking shield here, or the buckler, which are symmetrical. And so I didn't know, until I got a bit more into HEMA, I didn't know how these were predominantly used. And so I just kind of assumed that they were used sort of like Roman shields, with the grip being horizontal. And from what I see now, I mean, there are a lot of treatises on buckler use. The round Viking shield has a lot more to do with reconstruction. I don't believe there's any treatises that describe its use directly. However, whoever I see attempting to reconstruct combat with it, or just playing around with a Viking shield, people tend to hold it in a position where it will protect mostly your upper body, and that seems to be more comfortable holding the grip horizontally. So I think that even though these shields are symmetrical, it would be somewhat fair to say that the grip is used horizontally, both in the case of the Viking shield and in the case of the buckler, where the grip is used most often something like this. And obviously when you use the buckler with a sword, you might extend both your hands in such a way that your grip is pointing toward the enemy. So you might say this is closer to horizontal, but what I mean by horizontal is really this, the Roman way of holding a shield. And I don't believe that this is used very much in sword and buckler combat. I think that if you're going to hold the shield flat, you would be more likely to hold it like this, because then you can actually get your weapon on one side of the buckler or the other more easily than like this, where you would have to go on top or under to keep your hands protected. So basically, I think that round shields tend to be used with a vertical center grip. But since I didn't know that before making the kite shield, I made it with a horizontal grip, and it didn't work. And I think the main reason for that, how can I illustrate this? Let me use the Roman shield. So this kind of grip, horizontal, is very comfortable on my wrist when I'm sort of maximum, when my hand is maximum, like elbow height. If I have to go any higher than this, then my wrist gets a strange bend. I mean, I can straighten it out, but then I'm holding almost all of the weight on my thumb here. Whatever I do, if I try to hold a horizontal grip shield higher than my elbow, it starts becoming quite uncomfortable. And so I think that's why these shields had a horizontal grip. That's the principle that I'm trying to get at here, is that I believe that shields that are not symmetrical, that have an objectively horizontal center grip, I think they were meant to be used roughly elbow height or lower. And that is how I would use this scutum. I would have a gladius, or a wooden rudis here, and I would hold it something like this. I would kind of duck behind it, and the shield would never go much higher than my elbow. I might parry a few blows above my head, roughly at elbow height. I might even pull my head under more than I move the shield up. And then I'm going to be trying to get around the shield in all the ways that I can to attack the enemy. So yeah, this type of shield, that's what I think, basically. Elbow, height, or lower. Whereas, if I want to bring it higher than elbow height, all of a sudden, it becomes more comfortable to hold it like this. Because that feels much better on my wrist. So, like sort of between elbow height and shoulder height, and even higher, this is by far the most comfortable way to hold it. But obviously, this shield isn't meant to be used like that. If I hold it like this, I have way too much protection on the sides, and not much protection from my upper and lower body. I think the shape of this shield, with the grip so far in the middle, which leaves a lot of space to cover my upper body up here, is conducive to holding it low, elbow height or lower. However, with the kite shield, in order to have a boss that is higher than the center of balance of the whole shield, which is, by the way, the case with the Roman shield I was just holding as well, I made sure to put the grip somewhat higher than the center of balance, which makes the shield kind of hang nicely in a straight direction. If the grip is too low compared to the center of balance, if it was here, say, then the shield would tend to tip forwards and to rotate around that point. So somewhat higher than the center of balance is good. The thing is, with a kite shield, because there's so much matter removed from the sides here and it becomes so thin down low, that means that the boss is actually proportionally a lot higher on the shield than with a Roman shield. And so if I want to give myself decent cover with this shield, you'll notice that my hand pretty much has to always be higher than my elbow. When I use this to spar, I almost never bring it lower than my elbow, because that just opens up my shoulders and head to attack. And, well, you can't see my feet here, but I can quite adequately protect my legs without bringing the shield lower than this. I can simply move the bottom part a little bit if I want, or project it out a bit further, and that's ample protection for my feet. And so, so I think that is the ideal height of use for a vertical grip. So I think that vertical grips were used on shields that were meant to be held sort of at elbow height or higher. And indeed, if I bring this shield much lower than elbow height, if I had to hold it down here, which is more where my hand goes when I'm holding a Roman shield, that becomes very straining on my muscles, and even on my wrist, honestly. The moment it goes so low, it feels a lot more comfortable to hold it like this. But once again, like this, the shield is pretty useless. So, if you want me to just compare the two here, you'll see that if I use both grips horizontally, I have to keep the shields low, which is perfect for this kind of shield, not good for this kind of shield. Sorry about that, I keep on having to prevent my computer from shutting down. Anyway, so here I'm holding them like this, which is good for this shield, bad for this shield. But if I bring them higher than elbow height, then then the most comfortable way to hold them becomes like this, in which case it's good for this shield, bad for this shield. So I guess that was kind of a long, drawn-out way of saying that I think horizontal center grip shields were used at elbow height or higher, and, sorry, did I say horizontal? Vertical center grip shields were held at elbow height or higher, and horizontal center grip shields were held at elbow height or lower. That's my current thinking on the subject, and if any of you have any extra input, I'm sure there's many people out there who know a lot more about shields than me. I'm just getting started up, and I feel like I have already made some beginner's mistakes, just not thinking through human anatomy well enough. But like I said, fortunately, I discovered my mistake on this shield before attaching the grip, and I was able to make a new grip and fix all of that. And obviously, if you have symmetrical shields, then you don't have to worry about the direction of the grip, because they're symmetrical, so they could be used either horizontally or vertically, but still the same thing applies, I think, which is that the only way you would have a symmetrical shield that would be used with the grip horizontally, I think, is if you're going to be holding it relatively low, under elbow height. But to do that effectively, I feel that you would have to have a bigger diameter shield than this. A shield that comes up at least to shoulder height, so that it can be used a bit more in the fashion of a Roman scutum, which is to say that you can kind of crouch behind it like this and use it, use the flat of the shield a lot. That's perhaps another thing that I might say is when you're holding, maybe I should grab a sword here. So when you're holding a shield like this vertically, that allows you to actually keep your enemy at a greater distance, because you can easily use the edge of the shield forward as opposed to holding it like this, which blocks off, which you might think protects your body more. You're actually quite close to your body like this, and your opponent can actually come bring his shield flat against, his shield edge against your flat, in which case he can control your shield quite well. Whereas if you project your flat out like this, you can catch his weapons, his shield, his sword. You can actually alter, you can actually control quite a lot, and you can flip your shield to various sides and attack on both sides of it with that grip. If you're holding it horizontally like this, it becomes a bit harder to use your weapons on both sides of the shield without getting your... You see, my wrist here is in a really awkward position. I don't like attacking like this. Like this? No problem. This is quite stable. This isn't. And so I suspect that that's another generality, is that vertical gripped shields, I suspect, were used more easily with the edge pointing forward and then playing with the pivoting effects of the shield to attack on multiple sides. Whereas I pick up the horizontal shield again, I know I would be theoretically using a shorter sword with this type of shield, but I think it's harder to open up a line and attack on the side. I mean, on this side I can do it quite nicely, but on the other side, once again, it's a very awkward position for my wrist. I don't like that too much. I would hold a horizontally gripped shield much more in front of me. Another thing is that it actually forms a more solid defense, because the thing is, if the grip is horizontal, then the points around which the shield can pivot when an enemy weapon or shield pushes it is top and bottom. And the tops and bottom of these shields are very long, and heavy, so they have a lot of inertia. And what's more, if you bring the shield close enough, the top and bottom are easily resting against your shoulder and leg, and so they can't really move. And the shield can't move on the side here, or on this side, because of the horizontal grip, so my hand has a lot of strength to resist this kind of sideways pressure from an enemy. And like I said, the top and bottom pressure can be resisted with my body. Whereas with a shield like this, where the grip is vertical, the sidewards pressures are a lot harder to resist. If someone hits my shield hard here and it's extending in front of my body, then this is what happens. It spins out of the way, which opens up this side of my body as a target, which is a disadvantage and an advantage, I would say, because it makes it easier for your enemy to open the line, the space that your shield is protecting you in. But you can also use that to your advantage, because you can actually flip the shield and attack on this side, getting the enemy's weapon stuck on the wrong side of your shield, right? Because if I don't react fast enough and someone sticks a sword here, the sword can go into me. But if I react to that, I can let the sword pass by and attack on this side. So there you go. I guess a long, jumbly video full of thoughts on various shield types. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll definitely be making more videos on the general topic of HEMA in the future, and showing you more shields, because I've got a lot of shields that I've made, and I've been enjoying using them, so I'm sure I'll make other videos on the topic. Thank you for watching, and see you again soon!